So I am a member of Other Hearts Collective, which is a performance collective of several multidisciplinary artists like myself, based mostly in Toronto, Ontario. We come from a disparate array of backgrounds. I'm originally American, and I am a mad artist, self-identifying. I have complex PTSD. I was raised female in the world. I am LGBTQ. The other members of Other Hearts are also from similarly kind of disparate backgrounds. Most of us are LGBTQ. Most of us come from other places. We're born in other places other than Canada. We have non-binary members, racialized BIPOC members, disabled members. And our real point of interest is not so much, it is how we are different, but the ways in which we are different, the intersection points, and the ways in which we kind of come together as artists and really as collaborators and friends. So every different project that we do, we all switch roles basically inside of it. So for our project Looking Glass, which was a puppet project that we made at the very beginning of the pandemic over Zoom, long distance, I was the director of photography for about half of the film and the editor. And my collaborators, Yusuf and Hari, built the puppets themselves. And then we all kind of communally created a world for them. The other two wrote the thrust of the storyline. And then it was a very collaborative process, with the two of them kind of being lead artists on the project. So there's a bunch of different ways in which we kind of facilitate each other's visions and practices, and I find that by working with them, that then opens up opportunities inside of my own personal writing practice, or just my ideas of what's possible for myself as an individual. Especially navigating the world with PTSD, there's a bunch of different ways in which it makes life a little more, more than a little intense, and sometimes very difficult and alienating. And I found that through my work with Other Hearts, I've been able to learn how to allow myself more grace and space and forgiveness for just my own personal limitations, instead of really muscling against them, pushing against them. And by doing so, that allows me to create space for my collaborators, my friends, to really open up the heart to yourself is to open up your heart to everyone else around you, and to identify the fact that everyone has struggles, and we all have trauma in different aspects of our lives that we're constantly navigating. I think that the facade that we all, you know, especially in the social media digital age, the facade we have of like, we've all like keeping it together and only putting a specific view of ourselves out into the world, creates so much stratification and so much alienation. And in all of the work that I do, and in my life in general, because PTSD especially made me feel so alienated when I was younger, I hunger more than anything for connection. And so that's really what my work is about, as an artist and the way that I tried to navigate the world as a human being, I guess.